Honourable Prime Minister, Honourable Chairperson of the UPA, distinguished guests, I'm grateful to the Chairperson of the Bharatiya Mahila Bank for the warm welcome. I'm happy to add my words of welcome to the Honourable Prime Minister, the Chairperson of the UPA, the Governor, the Chief Minister, Sri Sharad Pawar, Sri Farooq Abdullah, Sri Praful Patel, Sri J.D. Seelam, ministers, members of parliament, members of the state legislature, Governor, Reserve Bank of India, bankers, customers, and all those who are in this distinguished gathering. On behalf of the government, I made a promise on February 28, 2013. I'm glad that we're able to fulfill that promise today, a very special day that marks the birth anniversary of a very special person, Srimati Indira Gandhi. I'd asked Sri M.B.N. Rao, former chairman Canara Bank, to head a committee to draw the blueprint for the Mahila Bank. The report was submitted in a record time of 2 months, and 6 months later, after working round the clock, we are here today at the inauguration of the bank, with several branches being opened simultaneously, even as I speak. I wish to recognize the presence of Sri M.B.N. Rao, the other members of the committee, and the members of the interim board of directors, and I thank them for their splendid work. This morning, the board inducted new directors. Sri M.B.N. Rao alone stepped down, and what we have is an 8-member, all-women board of directors. I welcome the all-women board of directors and wish them success in their endeavor. Empowerment of women is one of the articles of faith of the UPA government. The Bharatiya Mahila Bank is not, I repeat not, a symbol of empowerment of women. It is the substance of empowerment of women, along with many other measures that the government has taken and will take in the future. Only 26% of women in India admit to having a bank account. On the other hand, 4 public sector banks, including State Bank of India, and several private sector banks have a woman at the head of the bank, and I'm glad many of them are here today. The obvious conclusion is that, despite good intentions, there is deep-seated bias at the institutional and individual levels against women. Since fewer women than men have bank accounts, fewer women are able to get loans. Per capita credit in the case of women is 80% lower than in the case of men. Hence, the need for a bank that predominantly serves women, some men will also be served, that predominantly serves women, from the self-help groups to the small business women, and from the working woman to the high net worth individual. Bank credit is expected to grow at a compounded annual growth rate of 16.5% during the 20-year period from 2010 to 2030. That will mean a 20-fold increase from the level of credit in 2010. The deposit base is expected to grow at a compounded annual growth rate of 14.6%. That is 14 times the level of deposits in 2010. Assuming that the share of credit for women remains the same, which should not be the case, and the share must increase, but assuming that the level remains the same, even at that level, total credit to women will grow to rupees 25 lakh crore. There is therefore an opportunity to reach more credit to more women. I'm sure the Bharatiya Mahila Bank will seize the opportunity and multiply it many fold. Bharatiya Mahila Bank will be a universal bank and will provide every banking service and facility that is provided by comparable public and private sector banks. It will establish branches all over the country and in due course some branches abroad. We are proud that the first such bank is a public sector bank, and I sincerely hope that the private sector will emulate that example. I offer my felicitations to the chairperson, Usha Ananta Subramanian, and the members of the board of directors, employees, and the first customers of the Bharatiya Mahila Bank, and wish them great success. Thank you.